Welcome to Crust to Crust AM, a sub-podcast of Whatever Happened to Pizza at McDonald's, which is not a podcast at all, but is instead an investigative journalism program, or IJP, where I ask the question, Whatever Happened to the Pizza at McDonald's? I'm your host, Brian Thompson. Today, I present part three of my investigation into the extraterrestrial activities surrounding Pomroy, Ohio, final resting place of McDonald's pizza. In parts one and two, I recounted the story of traveling sewing machine salesman Woodrow Derenberger, who claimed to come into contact with a nudist extraterrestrial named Indrid Cold while passing through Pomroy. Later study revealed that Indrid Cold had been encountered by others in the area, specifically in the nearby West Virginia town of Point Pleasant. Concurrent with these encounters were sightings of a winged humanoid creature known as the Mothman. After a terrible tragedy in which a Point Pleasant bridge collapsed, killing several people before they would ever get a chance to try McDonald's pizza, run-ins with both Indrid Cold and the Mothman seemed to decline. That is until the year 2017, in which several residents of Chicago, Illinois, a.k.a. Hot Dog City, reported terrifying close encounters with a winged humanoid resembling the Mothman. As Chicago is home to the U.S. Pizza Museum's McDonald's Pizza exhibit, plus the company that supplied wholesale pizzas to McDonald's restaurants located inside Walmart stores, plus the corporate headquarters of McDonald's itself, plus the newspaper at which worked a reporter who died under mysterious circumstances after writing about McDonald's pizza's possible return, I determined that McDonald's pizza and the Mothman must be inextricably linked. But since the nature of this sinister and powerful creature is unknown, I thought it prudent to seek protection for myself in the event of my own Mothman encounter. But when I called my local weapons supplier, I was advised to purchase a very expensive Assault Rifle 15, which, at this point in my financial story, is much like the rare mineral unobtainium at the heart of the plot of the film Avatar. That is, unobtainable. But as I went door to door in a particularly dangerous Los Angeles neighborhood to see if anyone would give me a used assault rifle in exchange for housekeeping or freelance investigative journalism services, I thought of another potential setback in my quest. More after this brief message from our sponsor, which, in accordance with our new advertising policy, will be read by an amoral robot.
Have you ever wondered why your teeth are so white no matter how much you brush them? It is because the government puts the dangerous chemical fluoride in our water. This is why you need a fluoride removal filter from the Sea Crane Company. Your teeth may become yellow, but you will experience the comfort of knowing you stopped the government from making you drink something. Fluoride removal filters. Now available from the Sea Crane Company.
Longtime listeners of this program know that original recipe McDonald's pizza is no longer available. I have tasked myself with both figuring out why it was removed from the McDonald's menu and with convincing McDonald's to bring it back. And an unfortunate side effect of this reality is that my hometown of Los Angeles contains few remnants of McDonald's pizza's existence. Whereas the Mothman may be attracted to Pomroy and Chicago due to their importance in the history of the product, I have no reason to believe it would venture far west enough for me to encounter it. And even though I have every reason to believe this is a dangerous creature, heck-bent on scaring people walking through parks in the middle of the night, I have come to the conclusion that shooting it with an assault rifle 15 would be a tactless move. Deadly force may save my life, but it would prevent me from questioning the Mothman about its interest in McDonald's pizza. And as my investigation is my entire life's purpose, turning a gun on the Mothman would be no different than turning a gun on myself. So, as I cannot afford to travel to Chicago, I must find some way to lure the Mothman to me, so that I might subdue it, inject it with some form of truth serum, and interrogate it about its fascination with McDonald's pizza. Luckily, there is a well-known proverb related to moths and what attracts them.
Los Angeles Park. Park Rangers. May I help you?
Hello, my name is Brian Thompson, and I'm wondering who I need to ask to get permission to light a giant fire near the Hollywood sign?
You're not going to be able to ask anyone. That's not permitted in the park.
Oh, really? Why is that?
Why fires are not permitted in the park?
Yes.
It's a hazard. It's a danger.
Oh, I see. Well, the thing is, I'm trying to attract an animal that's attracted to fire, and I believe that there are film productions around town that are allowed to create fires outside safely.
Let me transfer you to special events.
Okay, thank you.
Any permitting that's allowed, that's who you would talk to. Their number is 323-644.
Excuse me, one second, I'm writing this down. I'm sorry. 323. You said 644?
44.
644.
6252. One moment, please.
625. What was that last number? Hello?
Thank you for calling Griffith Park Special Events. Please leave your name and phone number, and I will give you a call back as soon as I'm back in the office. Thank you.
Can't take your call now. At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, simply hang up or press the pound key for further options.
Hello, my name is Brian Thompson, and I was transferred to you to see if I could get permission to light a giant fire somewhere near the Hollywood sign. I chose the Hollywood sign because it is a very recognizable landmark, and also because it is one of the highest points in the city. And I believe that that would be beneficial to me because the point of the fire is to attract a certain creature that's attracted to flame. Just give me a call back. My number is 3... ...8. Thank you. Hello, my name is Brian Thompson. I'm looking to hire a company to produce a very safe pyrotechnics display.
Okay. What kind of pyrotechnics display are you looking for?
Well, I'm looking to light a giant fire somewhere near the Hollywood sign.
Okay.
Safely.
Gotcha. Okay. Is this like on a show site or outdoors or?
This would be outdoors. The intention is to attract an animal.
Okay. Is this like for like personal use or for?
Well, I'm an investigative journalist. I'm currently pursuing a certain investigation that's going to require questioning a particular animal that is attracted by flame. So I figure it's one of the more visible areas around the city. I called the Park Service, and they did have some concerns about safety. And so I feel like if I had a safety plan for this event, when I'm talking to them, it might grease the wheel, so to speak.
Gotcha. Yeah, okay. I mean, we can definitely that's what we do for a living, is create safe and repeatable, you know, flames and pyro and things like that.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm just trying to think about the best way to go about it. I mean, if you're doing it outdoors and if you're talking to the National Park Service, you'd probably want, like, a propane-fueled flame, not just a natural wood-burning fire.
Yes, and why would that be?
Just because it's much more controllable, especially with, like, you know, the recent California fires. I'm assuming they would like to have a controllable fire, whereas, like, if you're using propane and valves, and that gives you the ability to literally turn on the fire, get it as big as you want, run it as long as you want, but then shut it off in an instant, whereas if you were doing, like, a giant wooden bonfire, once that thing's up, you know, it takes a lot of work, you know, water, shoveling, sand to get that thing out.
I'm particularly concerned about any kind of property damage, because I definitely can't afford that liability, and certainly I don't want to cause any loss of life either.
We cover all, like, the liability. Like, we're not going to do, not in this case of show, but we're not going to operate anything that would cause damage, so you wouldn't have to worry about getting, you know, your insurance. Our insurance would cover the burn.
Oh, okay. Perfect.
Yeah. Like, how long of a burn? Like, do you want to burn for, like, a minute? For an hour?
I'm not sure how long it'll take. It just depends on how long it takes to fly from the Chicago area to the West Coast. But I have to do more research into that. How much does it cost? Is it priced per foot of height of flame? or
not quite. It all depends. I mean, honestly, I would have to just, you know, run some numbers because I'd have to build probably something slightly custom for this. I mean, if we're trying to get it as big as we can, as high as we can.
So I guess I just need to talk to the Park Service, and I have your insurance that this can be done safely, and your insurance will cover any damages to property or loss of life.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Thank you for listening to Crest to Crest AM, a sub-podcast of Whatever Happened to Pizza at McDonald's, a proud part of the Pizza Plea Network. Do you know what happened to pizza at McDonald's? Do you remember it? Please send all correspondence to pizzaatmcdonalds@gmail.com. Visit our attractive website at www.pizzaatmcdonalds.com. You will find links to our Twitter and Instagram pages, as well as to our Teespring store, where you may purchase quality Whatever Happened to Pizza at McDonald's merchandise. To provide financial support, visit patreon.com/pizzaatmcd's, or to make a one-time donation, use our PayPal email address, pizzaatmcdonalds@gmail.com. I'm Brian Thompson.